how can we truly heal from trauma and past pain so that we can finally manifest our dream life and have a successful law of attraction practice. So in this video, I want to share with you some tips, advices based on my own personal experience that can help you about how you can heal and understand whatever triggers that you may experience from past pain and maybe trauma as well. And this also has a bit something to do with past lifetime. So we are of course going to talk about, you know, any issues that you may experience in this lifetime, but we are also going to dive in just a little bit about past life. I think this topic is really interesting. So if you are interested in that and you do believe in reincarnations, then keep on watching. Hello everyone, my name is Cindy and welcome back to my channel. If you are new here to my channel, then hello, welcome. In this channel, I do a lot of art painting videos, while I also like to talk topics about spirituality, personal growth, such as law of attraction, manifesting your dream life for your career, success, and so on. But just a disclaimer though, I am not saying that I'm able to diagnose you in any way, because I am not a licensed psychologist or a therapist. So I still highly recommend you to go to a professional if you think that you really do need help, because I myself, from time to time, I still go to a therapist or a licensed psychologist to help me with the other, you know, theoretical and medical things. I do learn a lot about psychology, I'm very interested in that, but in this video, I am going to focus more on what I do for myself to help myself. So this is more of like a personal growth, you know, sharing session, you can say, between me and you. So yeah, let's just dive into this topic. Now, when it comes to healing, for me personally, it's a lot about understanding where the trigger comes from, whether it's some type of trigger about love or about trust or about self-confidence, whatever it is important for us to know why we have that trigger. Where is it coming from? Is it because we experienced something bad with another person, or does it even go all the way back from childhood as well? It is important for us to be aware so that we can actually heal and transform it into the light. But I know that this can be tricky. It is very, very psychologically complicated. It's not easy at all. That is why there are still some things that you do need help from a professional, while on your day-to-day basis, you still do your best to help yourself. Because for me personally, no matter how many times I go to a therapist or a psychologist, if I actually don't do anything to help myself, then nothing will improve much, you know? So personal growth, self-love, self-care, all of those type of things is important as well. And I do often talk about law of attraction in this channel, and that is why I decide to do this video, because when you want to attract love, when you want to attract success and happiness into your life, but you are not really aware that there are some things that you need to work on within yourself first, then it can actually affect whatever law of attraction practice that you are doing. It can actually influence that. So this video is actually kind of a continuation of the previous video that I posted last week about any tips and input that I share with you. Why is it so important for you to heal so you can manifest better? So if you haven't watched that video, I recommend you to watch it first. I have the link in this video and down below in the description. And also throughout this video, as you may notice, I am showing you this digital illustration piece that I recently just created. So while I was painting this, I was channeling into the energy of healing and really, really connecting into that inner voice or that soul essence of you. And I think doing art like this can be very healing. So if you are into art therapy, then I would recommend you to do so. And that brings me to the first point, is that if you want to heal about anything really, if it's about love or about, you know, a broken friendship or trust, anything that you really want to heal from, it's great for you to just try something new, like try a new hobby, learn something new, learn a new skill. That is what I did, and it has really helped me tremendously. So what I did, the first step is definitely changing my lifestyle, because by changing my lifestyle, I am automatically bringing better energy into myself, which automatically also affect my spiritual growth. And by me growing and growing and improving myself in my spiritual practices as well, well, automatically it makes me realize better and become more aware of whatever things that I need to work within myself, because I am becoming more in tune with my intuition, with my inner voice, with my soul as well, with my higher self as well. Now, I know this topic can sound just a little bit esoteric or too spiritual, but then again, this is what I experienced, and I'm sharing with you in hopes that you can resonate with that as well. So, talking about lifestyle, where can you start? Well, this can be about your diet, this can be about exercising, this can be about fixing any bad habits. Maybe you sleep way, 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 way too late. I'm guilty of that. And then you wake up maybe at 3 p.m. or 4 p.m. I am so guilty of this. Back then, I just had a lot of issues about sleeping and my eating pattern, my habits as well. It was just so bad. But that's because I do deal with some type of mental illness. But then at that time, I just got so damn tired of it. And I told myself, I really have to change my life from now on, because if not, I will not get anywhere in life. I would not be able to be where I am today, what I'm doing right now. And back then, I also thought that if I keep letting myself be this way, I won't be able to reach my goals and have success. So, to my other second point is that you have to ask yourself, do you really, really want to achieve your goals? Do you really want to do something that you're passionate about? Well, of course you do, right? And you know that you deserve it. And so that is why you have to find ways to trigger that spark, that passion again, so that you are ready to live life. Because for me personally, ever since I changed my lifestyle, which includes my diet, exercising, you know, I try meditation, yoga, trying new hobbies, going out there with friends, having fun, just do a lot of activities, you know, it really helped me to see and experience more things in life. Especially when you do connect with nature, whether you want to go out there, take a stroll at the park, or maybe at the beach, or maybe you go swimming somewhere, anything that has to do with connecting, you know, with nature, with the element of nature, even by bringing in plants into your room, it can actually really uplift your energy. So in this, you know, video, I also want to talk about the importance of energy work, whether you want to learn Reiki, whether you want to learn acupuncture, for example, or that you want to get a session for yourself. Basically, anything that has to do with energy work, meditation, any activities that is relaxing and, you know, just really nice and bring you a peace of mind, that can definitely help you in this healing journey. Now, when it comes to past life, this is also really tricky, but I have heard and seen it myself how incredibly powerful a past life regression can be. Now, a lot of people call this past life regression, but if you don't understand, it's basically a healing session with a professional or with a therapist that they know this type of things, you know, past life and hypnotherapy, things like that. They know what to do. So if you want to try past life regression or past life healing, I would just say do your own research first, because every therapist, they have their own ways, you know, they have their own style of healing. Some of them would just teach you meditation and art therapy even sometimes, and some of them would go all the way to hypnotherapy session. So it just really depends. I highly recommend you to go and do your own research. But this is really interesting, because I have heard and seen it myself how incredibly powerful past life healing can work for you. It can even heal physical illness or any issues that you might have. Now, this is actually a story from the friend of my own mother. She said that her friend, this guy, he has a pretty bad asthma problem, and no matter where he goes to a therapist or a doctor, nothing is really helping. And then at one time, he decided to go and try to have a past life healing session. So he got into this hypnotherapy session and found out that apparently in the past lifetime, he was caught in this burning building, and then he was trapped in a room, and he died because of the intensity of that hot smoke. And because of that trauma, energy is still clinging onto his soul, into his like soul fragment. When he reincarnated again into this lifetime, somehow he still bring that trauma, and it manifested into the form of having asthma problem. And other than that, I've also heard other people that have just just really weird and random fear, because they know that they never experienced any type of trauma in this life, as in their childhood, but yet somehow they are so damn scared of this one thing. You know, anything, you can just imagine anything. For example, there is this person that is so scared of a tiger, but this person has no issue or whatsoever with a tiger. They're just really, really scared of tiger. And when this person got into a past life healing and saw that in that past life, apparently he was attacked by a tiger and he died there. So I would also suggest, if you are into that, then past life regression can actually really help to take a look at whatever trauma, whatever trigger and past pain, or even unfinished karma as well, that you can learn so that you can heal and finally finish the cycle, finish that toxic pattern in this lifetime once and for all. Other than that, of all of the things that I have been sharing in this video, for me at least personally, the most powerful healing is definitely self-empowerment. It's a lot about learning and accepting who I really am, you know, my authentic self, by doing art and doing videos like this, sharing topics like this, because this is who I really am, and not feeling weird about it. So if you have any passion, if you have anything, you know, anything special about yourself and unique, then go do it. Go express it out loud into the world and don't feel ashamed about it. That is actually very healing, you know, because as you take that power back into you and not letting people criticize you badly or judge you or anything, well, that is very empowering, right? And when you feel empowered, you know that you are healing within, because you are not letting any toxicity affect you anymore. So when it comes to love, especially, a lot of us get really badly hurt in terms of love relationship. Well, taking back your power, feeling empowered, personal growth, self-love, self-care, all of that jazz, you know, it helps you to heal from whatever pain, from whatever heartbroken, you know, feeling that you experience. Because at one point you will say, you know what, F it, I'm going to drop this, I'm going to move on, this is not even worth my time, not even worth my energy, and I deserve something better, I deserve more, and I'm worthy of it, you know. So that is, yeah, I think that's it. That is the video and all of the topics that I want to share with you today. I hope this video is helpful. If you are interested to get to know me more personally, you can always contact me on my Instagram at amorinet. If you are interested in purchasing any of my art pieces or ordering a special commission art piece as well, all of that info is in my website and my shop as well. You can just check out www.cindyantoinette.com. All complete links, email and info is down below in the description. So yeah, that's it, and I will see you soon.